As you go to create your filters, it's very common that you'll need to use regular expressions to really get them to do what you want them to do. And regular expressions are most commonly referred to as regex. And this is a language that is used to describe a search pattern. It allows you to use essentially very powerful wildcards. Let's say, for example, that our office had the following IP address range, and we wanted to exclude this range from ever capturing data in Google Analytics. We would write regex, which would look like this. And here's how this breaks down. When we see the slash, this means that the character that comes after that slash needs to be interpreted literally. You see, the period is actually a regular expression for matching any single character. So if we simply left the dots in the IP address, then the regex would use that to match any other character. So we have to use that preceding slash. Now, at the very end, you'll see the D, which is shorthand for any number 0 to 9, the list of numbers from 0 to 9, and then the asterisk means 0 or more of any character. And this will essentially allow us to capture that entire range of IPs in one simple format. Now, regex can get incredibly complicated, and this is by no means meant to be a comprehensive overview. There are plenty of resources right here and around the web to help you get familiar. But I do want to show you the ones that you'll encounter most often and the ones that are really relatively easy to use. The first is the pipe symbol. I use this one very, very often. And this is used to create an OR match. Let's say I'm setting up a filter and I want to include my blog, store, and article directories. I would simply put blog, pipe, store, pipe, article, and now it's going to be blog or store or article. And this is important because sometimes when you create filters, you'll set up a filter for blog, then you'll add a new filter for store. But because filters fire in order, they don't naturally create an OR mechanism. So if I filtered out blog and then I fired another filter for store, store is not going to exist because I've already filtered for blog. So at the very high level, I would create this filter with the OR statement. Next, you can use a caret to indicate that something starts with this word. Let's say I had numerous contact pages. I had a contact-sales, contact-customers, contact-clients, and so on. If I use the caret symbol, contact, it's going to find anything that starts with that term. Contrary to that, I can use a dollar symbol at the end of a term to indicate that I want everything that ends in this word. So let's say I had store-order, contact-order, and so on. I would put the dollar sign, and that would find anything that ends with it. And finally, when you include either letters or numbers in between a bracket with a dash symbol, you're going to create a list. If I had page-AA, page-AB, and so on, I could match that with the following regular expression. Now, this is very touch and go with regular expressions, but these are the ones that you encounter most commonly.